ViewMotion Update has finally been released, so let's take a quick look to all the features that have been introduced. First, to download the update, start the Epic Games Launcher app. Click on Unreal Engine on the left, and then on the ViewMotion menu. From here, select version 2024.1.1 from the drop-down menu, and click on the pink Update or Install button to proceed with installing the update. First big news in the ViewMotion library. 62 new trees of the highest quality from all over the world have been finally introduced. Like the trees already in the library, these are composed of their three life versions, young, adult, and old, which actually increased the total number of trees added to the ViewMotion library to 186. These include coconut, avocado, sugarcane, and Italian maple. All these trees, in addition to being of high quality, also introduce a fantastic new feature applicable to any ViewMotion and Megascan plant, but especially to all foliage materials. The sway command allows all vegetation to sway, based on how strong the wind action is set in the weather menu, of course, under the environment settings. This new feature applies perfectly also to foliage material, which, combined with the wind option, allowing all 3D models downloaded from the web and imported into ViewMotion to come to life. Anyway, we don't find oscillation only with the foliage material. With version 2024.1.1, also the fabric materials, by activating the wind command, will allow all the surfaces on which they are applied to move depending on the intensity of the wind. Thanks to this wonderful new feature, it will no longer be necessary to import 3D models of animated 3D curtains into ViewMotion to have a rendering of moving curtains, especially in video creation. I'd like to take just 20 seconds, I promise, to inform you that I'm creating the ViewMotion Masterclass Learning Portal, where I will guide you through the fantastic world of ViewMotion, whether you're a beginner or an expert. Click on the link in the description of this video to stay updated on all the news and secure an exclusive discount at launch. Pre-register now using your email. Thank you so much for the support and enjoy the video. Other great news concerns HDRI, where finally now, having the match sound to HDRI command active, the sound intensity, color, and size commands are now extracted directly from the HDRI, and you will no longer have to find the right compromise between ViewMotion sky and sound settings. The only limitation at the moment is that this new command is only applicable to HDRI backgrounds that you haven't downloaded so far, and to those that you import from outside. In both cases, this tool works best with daytime backgrounds. This new addition was strongly desired by everyone, and I'm talking of course about the randomized UV. In the UV section of any material, from now on you will find a new box that once activated will randomize the UVs, so as to avoid repetition and make it more realistic and natural. Officially, this new command works best with ground materials such as soil, grass, and pebbles, but personally I have found it to be great even when used with materials of wood grains, concretes, marbles, leathers, and so on. At the moment, it doesn't make sense to be used on materials that assume neat joints or patterns such as parquet, bricks, stone veneer, so on. A very small update also concerns the statistics menu, which can now be docked to the right of the library and contains some additional information than before, such as indicating the number of lights, objects, and materials within the scene. The last command mentioned is camera roll, which can be activated during image creation and allows you to rotate the camera on an axial basis. There is still one last addition that concerns sequences, but not being familiar with this type of media, I prefer to leave the word to more experienced users. In any case, in the description, you will find a link to the official ViewMotion website where all the new features of this new update are listed. Thank you so much for watching this video to the end, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future content, like the video so you can help me with the algorithm, and suggest me in the comment what topic you'd like me to cover in the next video. That said, I wish you a good day or evening, and see you very soon. Ciao!